मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टूडेज क्लास वी विल सी अबाउट द फर्स्ट ईयर बीएससी नर्सिंग सप्लीमेंट्री एग्जामिनेशन नवंबर 2017. सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन वाज, डिस्क्राइब द ओवेरियन एंड यूट्राइन चेंजेस ऑकरिंग ड्यूरिंग नॉर्मल मेंस्ट्रुअल साइकिल, मेंशन द इंपॉर्टेंट हार्मोन्स इन्वॉल्वड इन ईच फेज एंड व्हाट इज LH सर्ज. Ovarian changes during menstrual cycle include the change in the ovary during each menstrual cycle occurring two phases. They are, first is the follicular phase and second one is the luteal phase. Ovulation occurs in between these two phases. So what is follicular phase? Follicular phase extends from the fifth day of the cycle until the time of ovulation, which takes place on 14th day. Maturation of ovum with development of ovarian follicle takes place during this phase. Ovarian follicles are the glandular structures present on the cortex of the ovary. Each follicle consists of ovum surrounded by epithelial cells, namely granulosa cells. The follicles gradually grow into mature follicle through various stages. Second is luteal phase. Luteal phase extends from the 15th day to 28th day of menstrual cycle. During this phase, corpus luteum is developed and hence this phase is called luteal phase. The corpus luteum is a glandular yellow body developed from ruptured diaphyne follicle after the release of ovum. It is also called yellow body. Uterine changes during the menstrual cycle. During each menstrual cycle, along with ovarian changes, uterine changes also occur simultaneously. Uterine changes occurs in three phases. They are, first one is menstrual phase, second is proliferative phase, and third one is secretory phase. First is the menstrual phase. After ovulation, if the pregnancy not occur, the thickened endometrium shed or discomated. This discomated endometrium expels out through vagina along with blood and tissue flowing. The process of shedding the exfoliated uterine lining with the blood and fluid is called menstruation or menstrual bleeding. It lasts for 4 to 5 days. This period is called menstrual phase or menstrual period. Second is proliferative phase. Proliferative phase extends from the 5th day to the 14th day of menstruation, that is, between the day when the menstruation stops and the day of ovulation. It corresponds to the follicular phase of the ovarian cycle. At the end of the menstrual phase, only a thin layer, that means around 1 mm of endometrium remains, as most of the endometrious stroma is descamated. And third is secretory phase. Secretory phase extends from the 15th to 28th day of menstruation, that is between the day of ovulation and the day of menstruation of the next cycle commence. After ovulation, the corpus luteum is developed in the ovary. It secretes a large quantity of progesterone along with a small amount of estrogen. Estrogen causes further proliferation of cells in uterus so that the endometrium becomes more thick. Progesterone causes further enlargement of endometrial stroma and further growth of the glands. Mention the important hormone involved in each phase. Regulation of ovarian changes, the follicular phase. Biological clock responsible trigger the cyclic event or the pulsatile secretion of GnRH at about 2 hours due to some mechanism that is not clearly understood till date. And pulsatile release of GnRH stimulates secretion of FSH and LH from anterior pituitary. And LH induces the synthesis of androgens from theca cells of growing follicle. And FSH promotes erythromous scab activity in granulosa cells of the follicle, resulting from conversion of androgens into estrogen. It promotes follicular development. And estrogen is responsible for development of growth of diaphyne follicle. It also stimulates the secretory activities of theca cells. And estrogen also exerts double feedback control on GnRH. Luteal phase. The role of LH. Ovarian changes during the luteal phase depend mainly on the LH or luteinizing hormone. And follicular stimulating hormone, it maintains the secretory activity of corpus luteum and stimulates lutein cells to secrete inhibin, which term inhibits the FSH secretion. Regulation of uterine changes. Uterine changes during menstrual cycle are influenced by estrogen and progesterone. Proliferative phase. During proliferative phase, the repair of damaged endometrium occurs mainly by estrogen. Estrogen stimulates proliferation of cells in the endometrial stroma and development of uterine glands and appearance of blood vessels in the endometrial stroma. Secretory phase. The secretory phase of uterine changes coincides with the luteal phase of ovarian cycle under the influence of FSH and LH from anterior pituitary. The corpus luteum secretes large amount of progesterone and small amount of estrogen. Progesterone is responsible for endometrial changes along with estrogen during this phase. And menstrual phase. If the pregnancy does not occur, menstrual phase occurs during the last 2 days of secretory phase, that is 2 days prior to the onset of menstruation. Secretion of large quantity of progesterone and estrogen from the corpus luteum inhibit the secretion of FSH and LH from anterior pituitary by negative feedback. The absence of LH and FSH, corpus luteum becomes inactive and start regressing. Sudden withdrawal of ovarian hormones, progesterone and estrogen occurs and it leads to menstrual bleeding. What is LH surge? LH is important for ovulation. Without the luteinizing hormone, ovulation does not occur even with a large quantity of FSH. The need for excessive secretion of LH for ovulation is known as the ovulatory surge for LH or luteal surge. Hypothalamic neuroprogesterone along with the elevated estrogen from the ovaries allow for the surge release of the gonadotropin releasing hormone that triggers the pituitary luteinizing hormone or LH surge. Explain the various lung volumes and capacities with the help of diagram and internal vital capacity. The lung volumes are of four types. The first one is tidal volume. Tidal volume is the volume of air breathed in and out of the lungs in a single normal quiet respiration. It's around 500 ml. Inspiratory reserve volume. Inspiratory reserve volume, an additional volume of air that can be inspired forcefully after the end of normal inspiration. Normal value is 3300 ml. Expiratory reserve volume. Expiratory reserve volume is the additional volume of air that can be expelled forcefully after the normal expiration. Normal value is 1000 ml. Residual volume is the volume of air remaining in the lungs even after a forced respiration. That is around 1200 ml. Lung capacities of combination of two or more lung volumes. The lung capacity, first one is inspiratory capacity, the maximum air of the volume that is inspired after normal respiration. It includes tidal volume and inspiratory reserve volume, that is comes around 3800. Vital capacity is the maximum volume of air that can be expelled out forcefully after a deep inspiration. It includes inspiratory reserve volume and expiratory reserve volume and with tidal volume. So it is comes around 4800 ml. Functional residual capacity. It is the volume of air remaining in the lungs after a normal expiration. That means after normal tidal expiration. It includes expiratory reserve volume and residual volume. It comes around 2200 ml. The total lung capacity is the volume of air present in the lung after a deep inspiration. It includes all the lung volume that comes around 6000 ml. This is the picture which shows the lung capacities. Functions of CSF. First one is the protective function. The specific gravity and of the brain and the CSF more or less same, and the brain floats in the CSF. When the head receives a blow, CSF act like a cushion and prevent the movement of brain against the skull bone, thereby prevents the damage of the brain. Regulation of cranial content volume. If the cranial content increases in volume, there is an increase in the absorption of substance into venous sinus. It happens in case of cerebral hemorrhage and tumors in brain. Medium of exchange. CSF is a medium through which many substances, particularly the nutritive substance and the waste materials, are exchanged between blood and brain tissue. Second, the fourth question is Parkinson's disease. It is a slow, progressive, degenerative nervous system associated with the destruction of brain cells which produce dopamine. It's named after James Parkinson, so it's also called Parkinson's disease or paralytic agent. Causes. It occurs due to lack of dopamine caused by damage of basal ganglia. It is mostly due to destruction of substantia nigra and nigrostrial pathway, which is a dopaminergic fibers, viral infections of brain like encephalitis, cerebral arteriosclerosis, injury to basal ganglia, destruction or removal of dopamine in basal ganglia. It occurs mostly during long-term treatment with antihypertensive drugs in unknown cases. Signs and symptoms: tremors. In this condition, tremor occurs at rest but disappear while doing any work, so it is called static tremor or resting tremor. Slowness of movements. Over the time of movement starts slowing down and it takes long time even to perform a simple task. Gradually, the patient becomes unable to initiate the voluntary activity or voluntary movements are reduced. Poverty of movements. It is a loss of all automatic associated movements. Because of the absence of automatic associated movements, the body becomes statue-like. The face becomes mask-like due to the absence of appropriate expressions. Rigidity. Stiffness of the muscle in the limbs resulting in rigidity of limbs. The muscular stiffness occurs because of increased muscle tone, which due to the removal of inhibitory influence on gamma motor neurons. It affects both flexor and extensor muscles equally. So the lips become more rigid. Pillars condition is called lead pipe rigidity. Gait. The patient loses the normal gait. Gait in Parkinsonism called sustenance gait. The patient walks quickly in short step by bending forward as if going to catch up a center of gravity. Speech problem. They may speak very softly or sometimes rapidly. The words are repeated many times. Emotional changes. Person affected Parkinsonism are often upset emotionally. Dementia. In later stage of some patients develop dementia. Treatment. As it is due to lack of dopamine caused by damage of dopaminergic fibers, dopamine does not cross blood-brain barrier and the substance called levodopa which crosses the blood-brain barrier is injected. Since levodopa is converted to dopamine in liver, some side effects occur due to excess dopamine content in liver and the blood. Antidiuretic hormone. Antidiuretic hormone or ADH is secreted mainly by the supraoptic nucleus of hypothalamus. It is secreted by paraventricular nucleus in small quantity. From here, this hormone is transported to posterior pituitary to nerve fibers of hypothalamo-hypophyseal tract by means of axonic flow. The actions of ADH have two actions. First one is retention of water. Major function of ADH is retention of water by acting on the kidney. It increases the facultative reabsorption of water from distal convoluted tubule and collecting duct in the kidney. In the absence of ADH, distal convoluted tubule and collecting duct are totally impermeable to water, so reabsorption of water does not occur in the renal tubules and dilute urine is excreted. This leads to loss of large amount of water through urine. This condition is called diabetes insipidus and the excretion of large amount of water is called diuresis. Second action is vasopressor action. In large amount, ADH shows vasoconstrictor action, particularly causes constriction of arteries in all parts of the body. Due to vasoconstriction, the blood pressure increases. However, the amount of ADH required to cause vasopressor effect is greater than the amount of required to cause antidiuretic effect. Regulation of ADH. ADH secretion depends upon the volume of body fluid and osmolality of the blood body fluids. Potent stimulants of ADH secretions are decrease in the extracellular fluid and increase osmolar concentration in extracellular fluid. What are the pancreatic enzymes? Describe any one detail. So pancreatic enzymes are divided into proteolytic enzyme, lipolytic enzyme and amyolytic enzyme. Proteolytic enzymes are trypsin, chymotrypsin, carboxypeptidase, nuclease, elastase, collagenase. Lipolytic enzymes are pancreatic lipase, cholesterol, ester, hydrolase, phospholipase A, phospholipase B, colipase, bile salt, activated lipase. Amyolytic enzyme is pancreatic amylase. And here we will see in detail about trypsin. Trypsin is a single polypeptide. It is secreted by inactive trypsinogen, which is converted into active trypsin by endokinase. Endokinase is also called endopeptidase and secreted by the broad cells of duodenal mucous membrane. Once formed, trypsin itself activates trypsinogen by means of autocatalytic or autoactive action. Trypsin inhibitor. Trypsinogen is activated only when it reaches the small intestine. If trypsin is activated when it is in the pancreas, it may hydrolyze the pancreatic tissue protein, resulting in pancreatic damage. But its activation in secretory cells, acini and ducts of pancreas, is prevented by the inhibitor. Actions of trypsin. First one is digestion of protein. Trypsin is the most powerful proteolytic enzyme. It endopeptidases and breaks the interior bonds of the protein molecule and converts proteins into proteoses and polypeptides. Curdling of milk. convert carcinogen in the milk into casein. Blood clotting, it accelerates blood clotting. It activates other enzymes like pancreatic juice, namely chymotrypsinogen into chymotrypsin, procarboxypeptidase into carboxypeptidase, proteolase to elastase, procolipase to colipase, and trypsinogen also activate collagenase, phospholipase A and phospholipase B. Autocatalytic action, once formed, trypsin itself convert trypsinogen into trypsin. Display eosinophil with the aid of diagram. Eosinophils have coarse, that means larger nucleus in the cytoplasm, which stain pink or red with eosin. Nucleus is bilobed and spectacle shaped. Diameter of the cell varies between 10 to 14 mm. Eosinophils play an important role in defense mechanism of body against parasites. During parasitic infections, there is the production of large amount of eosinophils which move towards the tissue affected parasite. Eosinophil count increases also during allergic disease like asthma. Eosinophils are responsible for detoxification, disintegration and removal of foreign proteins. Mechanism of action. Eosinophils neither markedly motile nor phagocytic like neutrophils. Some of the parasites are larger size. Still, eosinophils attack with the special type of cytotoxic substance present in the granules. When released over the invading parasite from the granules, this substance becomes lethal and destroys the parasite. This is a picture of an eosinophil. Enumerate hormones of anti-pituitary gland. Anti-pituitary gland, also known as the master gland because it regulates many other endocrine functions. Six hormones are secreted by the anti-pituitary. They are, first one is growth hormone. Growth hormone or GH is responsible for growth of almost all tissues in the body which are capable of growing. It actually increases the size of the number of size and number of cells. GH also acts as metabolism of three major types of foodstuffs in the body like protein, lipids and carbohydrate. GH secretion increases in hypoglycemia, fasting, starvation, exercise, stress and trauma in the initial phase of sleep. GH secretion decreases in case of hyperglycemia, increased fatty acid in the blood and later stage of sleep. Thyroid stimulating hormone. TSH is necessary for growth and secretory activity of thyroid gland. It has many actions on the thyroid gland. Adrenocorticotropic hormone. It is necessary for the structural integrity and secretory activity of adrenal cortex. Follicle stimulating hormone. It is a glycoprotein made up of alpha subunit and beta subunit. In males, it acts along the testosterone and accelerates process of spermatogenesis. In female, it is responsible for development of graafian follicle from the primordial follicle. It stimulates the theca cells of graafian follicle and cause secretion of estrogen, and it promotes aromatase in granulose cells, resulting in conversion of androgens into estrogen. Luteinizing hormone. It is a glycol protein and half-life is about 60 minutes. In male, LH stimulates interstitial cells of leading cells in testes. This hormone is essential for the secretion of testosterone in the leading cells. It stimulates the leading cells and quantity of testosterone secreted in proportion to the amount of LH available. Then prolactin. It is necessary for final preparation of mammary glands for the production and secretion of breast milk. It is act directly on the epithelial cells of mammary gland and cause localized alveolar hyperplasia. Oxygen dissociation curve. Oxygen dissociation curve is a graph with oxygen partial pressure along the horizontal axis and the oxygen saturation on the vertical axis, which shows on a S-shaped relationship. Oxygen and carbon dioxide are transported in the blood as a result of changes in the blood partial pressure. The oxygen dissociation curve is the expression of relationship between partial pressure of oxygen and oxygen saturation in the hemoglobin. The determination of oxygen dissociation curve depends on two measurements, that is PO2 with which the blood is equilibrated and proportion of hemoglobin that is saturated with the hemoglobin. A shift of the curve to the right indicates decreased affinity of the hemoglobin for oxygen and hence it increases to give up oxygen onto the tissue. A shift to the left indicates increased affinity and so the increased tendency of hemoglobin to take up and retain oxygen. This is the oxygen curve. The red line indicates a normal oxygen dissociation curve. The green indicates shift to the right side and the blue indicates shift to the left side. Answer briefly, draw and label a normal ECG tracing. This is an normal picture of a normal ECG tracing. Myasthenia gravis. Myasthenia gravis is a long-term neuromuscular disease that leads to varying degree of skeletal muscle weakness. It commonly affects the muscles of those of eyes, face, swallowing. It can result in double vision, drooping eyelids, trouble in talking, and trouble in walking. Onset can be sudden. Those affected often have a large thymus or develop thyoma. Initial main symptoms of MG, painless weakness of the specific muscles, not fatigue. The muscle weakness becomes progressively worse during the periods of physical activity and improves after a period of rest. Typically, the weakness and fatigue are worse towards the end of the day. MG generally starts with ocular eye weakness. It may be then progress to more severe generalized form characterized by weakness in the extremities or in the muscle that govern basic life functions. MG is autoimmune sympathy. A disorder occurs when immune system malfunction and generate antibodies that attack body's tissue. Functions of skin like protective, this we have seen in many question papers, they are protective function and protection from the UV rays. Sensory function, skin is the largest sense organ. Storage function, skin store fat, water, chlorine and sugar. Synthetic function, vitamin D3 synthesized with the help of UV light. Regulation of body temperature. Regulation of water electrolyte balance, excretory function like it excretes waste material like urea, salt and fatty substance, absorptive function and secretory function is sweat, it secretes sweat and sebum. The primary taste sensation. Primary taste sensation are divided into four groups each. Sweet taste produced mainly by organic substances like monosaccharides, polysaccharides, glycerol, alcohol, aldehyde, ketones and chloroform. Inorganic substance which produce sweet taste are called beryllium. Salt taste is produced by chlorides of sodium, potassium, ammonium, nitrates of sodium and potassium. Salt taste. Salt taste is produced by the hydrogen ion in acid and acid salt. Bitter salt produced by organic substance in picric acid and bile salt and inorganic substance like salt of calcium, magnesium and ammonium. Umami. It is recently recognized that taste sensation. It is a Japanese term means delicious. Receptors of this taste responds to glutamate, which is a common ingredient of Asian food. Composition of saliva. Saliva having water content of 99%, 0.5% and solid of 0.5%. Among this solid, it can be either organic substance or inorganic substance or gases. The organic substance again divided into enzymes and inorganic and mucin albumin like. Inorganic substances are sodium, calcium, potassium, bicarbonate and gas like oxygen, carbon dioxide and nitrogen. Normally glucose is absent in saliva but it is found in saliva during the diabetes mellitus. Gastric juice. Gastric juice secretion from different gastric gland. The volume is 1200 to 1500 ml per day. The reaction is acidic. The composition of gastric gland and water is 99.5%. The solids comes around 0.5%. They are organic and other organic substances are enzymes like pepsin, renin, gastric lipase, gelatinase, urease. Other organic and mucus intrinsic factor. Inorganic substances are hydrochloride, sodium, calcium, potassium, bicarbonate, chloride and sulfate. Functions of gastric juice have digestive function. Pepsin act on protein and convert protease, peptidose and peptidase. Gastric lipase act on butter, fat and convert to fatty acid. Gelatinase degrade gelatin type 1, 5 and 4 and collagen 5 into peptides. Urease act on urea and produce ammonia. Hematopoietic function. Intrinsic factor present in the gastric juice plays an important role of erythropoiesis necessary for the absorption of vitamin B12, which is known as an extrinsic factor from GIT to the blood. Protective function. The thick mucus protects the gastric juice, protecting the gastric wall. Functions of hydrochloride. Activate pepsinogen into pepsin, kills some of the bacteria that endures in the stomach, provides an acid medium for actions of hormone. Functions of testosterone. This include in the fetal life, it performs three functions like sex differentiation in fetus, development of accessory sex organs, and descent of the testes. Functions of testosterone in adult life include has two important functions in adult life, effect on sex organs and effect on secondary sexual characteristics. Myopia or short sightedness. It is that person can see near object clearly but not the far object. Maybe due to the elongation of eyeball due to the stress and strain, an increase in optical power of the lens. Treatment is by using biconcave lens. Cretinism. Neonatal hypothyroidism is decreased thyroid hormone production in a newborn. It's very rare case no thyroid hormone is produced. If the baby born with this condition, it is known as congenital hypothyroidism. If it develops soon after birth, it is called hypothyroidism acquired in the newborn period. The causes include hypothyroidism in newborn, and it can be caused by missing of poorly developed thyroid gland, pituitary gland that does not stimulate thyroid gland. The thyroid hormones are poorly formed and or do not work. A thyroid gland that is not fully developed is the most common defect. It occurs in about one out of every 3,000 births. Girls are affected twice than the boys. Treatment. Early diagnosis is very important. Thyroxine is usually given to treat hypothyroidism. Once the child starts taking this medicine, blood tests are regularly done to make sure thyroid levels are in normal range. Expectation of prognosis include getting diagnosed early usually to a good outcome. Newborns who are diagnosed and treated in the first month so usually have a normal intelligence. Untreated, mild hypothyroidism can lead to severe mental retardation and growth retardation. Nervous system goes through the important development during the first few months after birth. A lack of thyroid hormone can cause damage that cannot be reversed. Complications, mental retardation, growth retardation, and heart problems. Oral contraceptives in females. The drugs taken by the month to prevent the pregnancy that of three types, the classical or campaign pills, it contains moderate dose of synthetic estrogen and mild dose of synthetic progesterone. It should be taken 5 to 25 days of menstrual cycle, and withdrawal of the pills after 25th day cause menstrual bleeding. Sequential pills, this contain high dose of estrogen along with the moderate dose of progesterone. These pills are taken up 2 courses daily for 15 days from 5 to 20th day, and during last 5 days these pills also prevent ovulation. Mini pills or micro pills, this contain low dose of only progesterone and taken throughout the menstrual cycle, it prevents pregnancy without affecting ovulation. Progesterone increases the thickness of cervical mucosa so that the transport of sperm is inhibited, and also prevent implantation of the ovum. Thank you. Thank you for listening.